The extract step is the first step in an ETL pipeline. We will be creating the extract step to extract the data we need from the data source. By the end of this tutorial, you should be able to create an extract step for an ETL pipeline of your own. In this tutorial, we're going to decide what data we need to extract from our data source. We're going to be using API requests in order to extract that data. We're going to set up our ETL pipeline by creating a function that orchestrates our three different steps together, the extract, transform, and load steps. And we're also going to show you how you can optionally wait for multiple API requests if you need to pull data from multiple sources. We're going to be using a publicly accessible API from NASA as the data source for this tutorial. Specifically, we're going to be using the public NASA Exoplanet API. An exoplanet is a planet that orbits a star outside of our solar system. And the NASA Exoplanet API is an interface to their database full of exoplanets that they've been studying. In this tutorial, we're going to extract all discovered exoplanets from the Exoplanet API. This exoplanet data is the data that we're going to be using throughout this ETL process. We're going to take the raw data from the API, transform it, and then load it into another location. Before we get into this, let's talk about how you can apply what we're going to learn to your own datasets. Every source of data is unique, so when you're creating an ETL pipeline for your own data, here's some things that you should think through first. Spend the time up front thinking about what constraints your data source has and how you'll need to access it. You need to consider what you'll have to do in order to get the data that you need to work with. You'll need to also figure out exactly what data you need to source. The extract step is your chance to decide what data will be moving through the pipeline and how you need to transform it. The commonality between the example we're going to show and your own data is that you're likely going to be querying your dataset in some way. So the techniques that we're showing will still apply to your own data, whether it lives in a SQL database, MongoDB, an API, or anything else that you must request data from. So I've already created an index.js file and initialized a package.json. The next thing we need to do is we need to install the dependencies we're going to be using. We're going to be using the request and request promise dependencies in order to make our API calls. Next, I'm going to create the query and API call that we need in order to extract all the data from the Exoplanet API. So what I've done here is I've declared a variable called exoapiURL. That's the URL of the Exoplanet API that we need to hit with our API request. Then I've created a function called getAllPlanets, which is going to return a promise that will resolve with all the planets from the API. We're using requestPromise in order to create that API call to get the planets. We're passing in the exoapiURL as the URI, telling it that the method is a getRequest, and then we're also going to be passing query strings to this API URL. That's a particular quirk of this API, where we need to use query string parameters in order to tell it what table to select from, and also what format we want the data returned in. In this case, we're choosing JSON. And we're also telling requestPromise to parse the JSON response by passing JSON true into the options for requestPromise. What you need to know about this request is that it returns as a promise, which is going to resolve with an array of all of the individual planet records that we're going to be using to transform later on. Let's run this request real quick and log out some of the data that it outputs. So this is one planet record in our data set of exoplanets. This is the data that we're going to be transforming later on in this tutorial. The way we're going to plan to transform it is that we're going to change some of these key names, we're going to get rid of a lot of the data we don't need in here, and we're going to eventually compute new values based on some of these values that we see. We're also going to create a function which is going to be used to orchestrate the different steps in our ETL pipeline. I'm going to call this function startETLPipeline. Notice it's going to be an async function, which is going to allow us to use async await within the function. And the first step is going to be to use this extract function we created in order to extract the data. Since we're using async await, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this whole thing with a try catch block to catch any errors that get thrown while using async await. Now we have our ETL pipeline stubbed out. I've left to-dos for the transform step and the load step, which we're going to implement in later videos. Let's make sure that we start this ETL pipeline by calling the startETLPipeline at the bottom of this file. Let's go ahead and run this file and make sure that our extract step is working properly. Okay, we can see that we extracted all 4,084 planets from the Exoplanet API. The last thing I want to mention is that when you're working with your own data, it's likely that you'll need to make more than one request or query in order to get all the data that you need. In that situation, you'll likely want to wait for all that data to have been extracted before you move on to the next step. In order to do that, you should use promise.all to create a promise that will resolve once all of the requests or queries have finished. I'm going to demonstrate that real quick, and first we're going to comment out what we've already written here. Promise.all will take an array of all the promises that you want to combine into one single promise that resolves once all of them have finished. Let's say we need to make three requests to get all of our data. I'm going to use our getAllPlanets as a stand-in for whatever request you'd be making, so I'm going to put that in here three times. We can await the completion of this promise and use array destructuring in order to get all of the different requests out of it. So data A would refer to the first request that we made in here, data B the second, and data C the third. When you're using promise.all, it's going to execute all these requests simultaneously, so make sure you're careful not to overwhelm whatever resource you're querying. For our tutorial, we just need the one request, so I'm going to go ahead and delete this and uncomment what we've already written. In this tutorial, we decided what data to extract, and in this case, we're extracting all of the data available in the Exoplanet API. We used an API request in order to extract our Exoplanet data. We created the extract step, the first step of our ETL pipeline, while stubbing out the rest of the pipeline. And we showed you how to use promise.all in order to wait for multiple requests when extracting data.